Guys, welcome back to another video. This is Motivation for Young Christians. Welcome back to another episode of Bible Study. This is Bible Study episode 58. Today we're getting into Acts chapter 3 verses 1 through 11 when we're talking about Peter heal a crippled beggar. To begin, we're going to start off with a prayer by me. Then we're going to end off with a prayer by me. I will be led by me today also. If you guys can, please bow your head and close your eyes. Heavenly Father, we thank you, we praise you, we worship you, God. We thank you for this day that you made. I rejoice in me, God. We pray that now is about to get to the time of your word, God. We pray that your hands will bless and cover the word, God. I pray that iron will be able to sharpen iron, God. We pray that we continue to educate ourselves, God. We pray that you'll be able to give us revelations of this word today, God, to be able to understand it and get the message, God. In Jesus' name, holy name, amen. Now we'll begin into the reading for today. We're reading from the NLT version, Acts chapter 3, verses 1 through 11. Peter healed a crippled beggar. Verse 1 says, Peter and John went to the temple one afternoon to take part in the 3 o'clock prayer service. As they approached the temple, a man lame from birth was being carried in. Each day he was put beside the temple gate, the one called the Beautiful Gate, so that he could beg from the people going into the temple. When he saw Peter and John about to enter, he asked them for some money. Peter and John looked at him instantly, and Peter said, "Look at us." The lame man looked at them eagerly, expecting some money. But Peter said, "I don't have any silver or gold for you, but I can give you what I have. In the name of Jesus of the Nazareth, get up and walk." Then Peter took the lame man by the right hand and helped him up. And as he did, the man's feet and ankles were instantly healed and strengthened. He jumped up, stood on his feet, and began to walk. Then walking and limping, and praising God, he went into the temple with them. All the people saw him walking and heard him praising the Lord. When they realized he was a lame beggar they had seen so often at the Beautiful Gate, they were absolutely stunned. They all rushed out into amazement to Solomon's Colonnade, where the men were holding tight to Peter and John. And that marks for the completion of the reading of the word today. My biggest takeaway from the scripture today is the healing part. And I just want to recognize this. God know our needs in life. And the lame beggar was disabled, and his need was to be able to walk. And instead of being given money, he was given the opportunity to walk again. God saw his need and was able to deliver his need. I just wanted to point that out. God always will provide our needs. Needs for nothing in life. He will provide it for us to be able to continue our life. He'll always provide our needs and sometimes want. So I wanted to point out Lee's part. After this, he was praised. A miracle happened to the lame man, and he continued to praise the Lord because of that. And he came in to the temple with Peter and John to be able to continue to serve the Lord. And that's just very important that after his delivering, after his miracle, he just started praising the Lord, and he turned his life over to the Lord. At that point, he just continued to serve the Lord and be with him. And the people were very surprised, because the people see him every single day begging for money at the Beautiful Gate, and they were amazed by the miracle that have performed. And that was my biggest takeaway from today, that God will provide your needs and sometimes more. That's the biggest message and takeaway for today. Now we'll be going into our closing prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you, we praise you, we worship you, God. We thank you for this day that you've made. I rejoice in God, God. I pray that you continue to be with us, God. We pray this today as we just finish reading your word, God. We put your hand over us and cover the word, God. I just pray that we'll always be able to remember, God, that you'll provide our need, God, that you know our hearts, God, that you know the things that are needing of us, God. And I just pray for guidance and protection to everybody in this upcoming week. I pray that no conforming games, God, prosper, God. In Jesus' name, amen. This is the end of the video. Thank you guys so much for coming back to another episode of Bible Study. This is Bible Study episode 58 as we dived into Acts chapter 3, verses 1 through 11. If you haven't already, please like the video, subscribe. If you're new, please turn your post notification. That way, anytime I upload, YouTube will send you a notification. This is Motivation for Young Christian. I'll see you guys next week. Bye.